Chartering a super yacht has to be the ultimate luxury vacation. BOA VIDA, a 2023 Ocean Alexander 35R, blends style and performance. We met up with her charter manager, Lauren Littlejohn, to find out more about how BOA VIDA sets the tone for an awe-inspiring charter experience.
My name is Lauren Littlejohn. I am the charter manager for BOA VIDA. She debuted for charter in early 2024. A charter manager runs the commercial side of charter on the owner's behalf. So we help to promote the boat for charter across MLS platforms and other marketing avenues. We hold the boat's calendar as well as help to negotiate on the owner's behalf and create the bookings and facilitate the contracts.
BOA VIDA's versatile layout holds a few surprises, such as voluminous spaces and an impressive 7 wet bars on board. I asked Lauren to dive into the yacht's highlights, starting with the aft deck and the hydraulic swim platform.
BOA VIDA is a 116-foot Ocean Alexander. She's the 35R model, which stands for Revolution, and she is exactly that. I mean, from bow to stern, this boat is designed for guest spaces. Starting from her swim platform, she's got this hydraulic swim platform which sits just above the water when they're cruising. And at anchor, once the toys are all deployed, this space can lower into the water and allow for easy access for guests straight from the boat onto the water toys, including easy access set of stairs for anyone with limited mobility or who just wants some easier access. This area also gives you access to the beach club, which is unheard of a boat this size. It's large, it's got a conversation area, a wet bar, a full bathroom, as well as a gym, a dedicated gym on board a boat of this size. So BOA VIDA is equipped in the gym area with a tonal machine, resistance bands, adjustable dumbbells, yoga mats, anything that you would need to keep your routine up while you're on the water. There's also a wet storage area here, which allows for the crew to use this for the owner's private dive gear. Heading up to the main aft deck via a set of wide stairs is another conversation area. This features a plush U-shaped couch as well as an adjustable table. So this table rises or lowers depending on the atmosphere that you want to set, and also can be extended. So if you want to have a full meal, it's easily accommodating. A unique feature on board is what I call the picture window from this area into the beach club. This allows for guests that are on the main deck to take a look maybe at the teens that are enjoying the beach club, or maybe for someone with limited mobility who doesn't want to go all the way down to the beach club, to still be a part of what's going on down below, see everybody out playing with the water toys. From the main deck aft is access into the main salon via a automatic sliding door. And this is where you truly feel for the first time the magnitude of volume on this boat. The head space is incredible. They've got floor-to-ceiling windows that flank both sides and allow for a flood of natural light. To the starboard side is a wet bar as well as a fold-down TV. To the port is a conversation area, which is flanked with an oversized L-shaped couch, armchairs, and then this open plan salon also features, just forward of the conversation area, the formal dining. As you continue walking forward, you have access to the primary stateroom. A little bit different on this build than some of the other 35Rs is that the primary stateroom starts a little bit earlier. So they've taken out some of the crew storage and accommodated that to the master stateroom storage, including adding in a mini fridge, a credenza, and a workstation. This area also has large floor-to-ceiling windows, a king-size bed, his and her closets, and a beautiful ensuite. The ensuite features his and her toilets, as well as sinks, a large standing shower, and a jacuzzi tub. Another unique feature in this area is that the ensuite has a skylight. So this allows for extra natural light to flow into the ensuite, which is a beautiful addition. Heading down the staircase to the four lower staterooms, to the aft are two king VIPs, both of which mirror each other. And then forward are two twin cabins, both of which are convertible. All of these staterooms are equipped with ensuite and all are very well accommodated. Touching back to the versatility, the twin staterooms having this convertible option is wonderful for charter guests. If you've got friends on one trip, family on another, or couples on another, you really have the versatility to accommodate all types of groups. The Sky Lounge is my personal favorite deck. If I was on charter, this is where I would spend all of my time from day to night. This area has a large couch, conversation area, a smaller games table, and a full bar. The Sky Lounge also hosts a large screen TV. Again, I cannot stress enough, the beautiful windows throughout really allow for loads of natural light, as well as peaks of the beautiful waters in which you're cruising. And as you walk to the aft, this is where you'll find your al fresco dining in a large wooden table. You've got the barbecue out here, credenza so they can set up a buffet for breakfast and all sorts of other fun themed nights. The aft area transforms into another conversation area with large plush couches and the ability to see what's going down below. If you've got everybody out on the toys and you want to take a sneak peek while you're up, maybe enjoying some shaded coverage from the optional shading in this area, you really can be a part of all of the action. The last deck is the sun deck, and that's accessed via another set of stairs. This is the owner's current favorite spot on board. This area has a large oversized jacuzzi, flanked by sun pads, a full wet bar, drop-down TV, and then again, versatile seating. So this seating here has the ability to either sit facing forward or with a quick switch of the backs, you can sit to face backwards. This area has also been equipped with isinglass. So if you've got extra winds that are coming through or some rain and you still want to enjoy this area, with a quick zip, the captain and crew can make sure that this is protected in an enclosed area. The last space on board to talk about is the foredeck, and this is again another remarkable spot for guests to enjoy. There's a plush settee and table area, as well as a large sun pad, again with those seats that have the flexibility to face forward or backward. Versatility is a key word in this Ocean Alexander build, and you'll see it throughout. And also, the amount wet bars on board. You will be shocked. There are 7 of them that are available both inside and outside. I would start my day with a coffee on the main deck aft and jump in the water from the swim platform. I think I'd spend most of my day again on that bridge deck aft with lunch on board, maybe a beach setup, playing with all of the water toys. And if we're in New England for the day, taking their electric bikes out for a ride and seeing all of the areas that are offered both on land and by water. BOA VIDA has a plethora of water toys on board. Their towed tender is a 2023 Boston Whaler. They have 2 2-man glass bottom kayaks, 2 jet skis, 2 paddleboards, 2 sea bobs, and a plethora of other water toys, which include fishing rods, a trampoline, a beach setup, a karaoke machine, and so much more.
As a charter manager, Lauren deals with charter brokers representing clients every day, so she understands vessels that define luxury yachting, and offered these closing remarks.
BOA VIDA will be chartering throughout the Bahamas this winter before transiting up to New England for the summer season. To find out more information on BOA VIDA, you can contact your preferred charter broker.